There you go. Get you to go in then.
Is that set up already?
Mm-hmm.
It should be okay, huh?
Yes.
No line, Jeff.
Okay.
It's already set. There you go.
Just focus on interesting stuff until we walk in.
So, I guess that's enough.
Thank you. troubles come, my heart hurts.
Thank you.
Maybe not. Okay, he's coming back.
Reading from the book of Revelation. After this, I had a vision of a great multitude, which no one could count, from every nation, place, people, and tongue. They stood before the throne and before the Lamb, wearing white robes and holding palm branches in their hands. They cried out with a loud voice, "Salvation comes from our God, who is seated on the throne, and I am the Lamb." For this reason, they stand before God's throne and worship Him day and night in His temple. The one who sits on the throne will shelter them. They will not hunger or thirst anymore, nor will the sun or any heat strike them. For the Lamb who is in the center of the throne will shepherd them and lead them to springs of life-giving water, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. This is the word.
Thank you.
Jesus said, "Take away the stone." Martha, the dead man's sister, said to him, "Look, by now there will be a speech. He has been dead for 4 days." Jesus said to her, "Did I not tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God?" So they took the great stone, and Jesus raised his eyes and said, "Father, may faith in you for hearing. I know that you always hear me. But because of God here, I have said this, that they may believe that you sent me." And when he had said this, he cried out in a loud voice, "Lazarus, come out." The dead man came out, tied hand and foot with burial bands, and his face was wrapped in a cloth. So Jesus said to the crowd, "Untie him and let him go." So many of the Jews who had come to Mary and see what he had done began to believe in him. The gospel of the Lord. Worship the Lord, Jesus Christ. Emily, Bella, Wilfred, Mariana, Rufford, Anita John, and all of you who are participating in this funeral mass. We know that grieving is, we know that grieving a tremendous loss of esteem is undeniably painful. But the burden of grief is more bearable when we realize that all people we love so much are grieving together with us. In the midst of grief, pain, and deep sadness, you are not grieving alone, because all of you are supporting one another, and we all pray for the eternal rest of us. This family support is really important because it helps us to come together and serve despite the unfortunate event of death. Even when words are limited to express our deepest sympathies, the power of making ourselves present in this time of grief may give you a profound sense of comfort, consolation, and peace. Sharing your suffering with your family and friends may help us alleviate those feelings of grief. This is then an appropriate time to acknowledge the importance of our family to process the past tragedy happened. To grieve and suffer in the presence of your loved ones not only is placed your vulnerability as a human being, but also empowers you to strengthen your bond of love, care, and understanding in the face of adversity. Even though the situation of death brings about so much change, this kind of affliction eventually would make you stronger, more resilient, more curious about the mystery of life. Your vivid memories, your endless love for the city, and your firm faith in heaven will always keep our curiosity alive in your hearts. Even if he has already died, he will always give you new because of what he has taught you. His generosity, his profound sense of service, his commitment to his family and his work, his concern for the underprivileged and the poor, his poetry are nonetheless his legacy and invaluable God. And for that reason, I do believe that he has to be honored faith in Jesus Christ, likewise, plays a very important role in bringing an amazing sense of hope. Although the loss of the sea may put all of you in a dire and difficult situation, your belief in the afterlife will enable you to trust in a merciful God who has prepared a special place for his feet in heaven. Death is just the pathway to what we are anticipating as believers in the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Death does not have the last word. Rather, the persons who enter into an affinity everlasting life. Brothers and sisters, as we entrust the soul of our brother's feet to our merciful Father, we pray together for the hope of his soul and his eternal rest. Amen. May the soul of our brother's feet and the soul of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Please stand. God and the Almighty Father, raised Christ the Son from the dead, with confidence we ask you to save all people living in heaven. The response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For saving, the baptism of the Holy Spirit to the eternal life. That he may be made into the country of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Receive in the meeting the body of Christ, the bread of life, that he may be raised up on the last day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may be happy to reward their interests, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. For the family and friends of our brothers and that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his son Lazarus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
All of us assemble here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, our shepherd and our community, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayer of our proud father, brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Please be seated. And please join in singing Here I Am, Lord, number 370 in our front of you, number 370. Here I am, Lord.
You are the only one.
At the time he went to prayer and ended willingly into his passion, he stood forever and keeping thanks and broken and gave to them his desire, saying, "Hail, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when Sarah was sentenced, he stood to time, and one among the evil men gave his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from him. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out in you for many, for the forgiveness of
the mystery of
therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that our taking of the body and the blood of Christ, you may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world and bring her to fullness of salvation, together with Francis powerful and family commission and all of clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have borne us need in the hope for the resurrection, our brothers and sisters, and all who have died in the mercy. Welcome them into the light of true faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with blessed Apostle, and all the saints who have peace with us today, who may merit and be offered to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Help us in your mercy. We may always be from sin and
They are all distressed as they await the blessed hope and they come to our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom of the Father, the glory of your Son.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, keep my people when you can keep those not in my faith, but in my faith, but in the church. And graciously grant our peace to me in a hope that we can go. Believe and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with
you all. That I ever recover a sign of peace.
Let us read the instruction in the Bible of this distribution of all communion, but for most of you who are participating in this communion of man, if it has not happened, you can be the first priest or the minister in close to the arms of the Jews, Christian Church. And all of you who are Catholic, you can receive close communion, but also you are not participating.
Thank you.
is fine communication. I can tell you all what it is. Currently, it's that our brother's here because he was not advised. He got a very tender this new life. Our first hope is that we shall do the same. Let us have comfort, his family, his friends, and to increase our desire for the joy of the Lord. We ask it through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord,
whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by the our brother Stephen, may come to the eternal kingdom of Christ, to live and reign forever and ever. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, Father and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, the last peace and
thanks. Thank you.
Now you are.